Welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing well. Welcome back to Def Leppard Saturday. If you don't know what Def Leppard Saturday is, as always, it is where we take a deep dive into Def Leppard's discography. We are starting up Euphoria today. Wow. In the description box, you guys will have the link to my Def Leppard Saturday playlist where you can catch up on all of our Def Leppard goodies if you're not caught up. That includes us checking out the albums High and Dry, Pyromania, and Hysteria. So go check that out. Today, as I said, we are starting Euphoria, so that means the first two songs on that album we are doing today, and that is Demolition Man and Promises. Let's jump into it. You know the drill. Like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications of when I upload, and let's start checking out the new album. Real quick, before we jump into Demolition Man, I want to show you Vin. So I normally have a dog and a cat in the background of my videos, and one of them, the cat, his name is Vin, the cream colored one. He's actually being really cute. He's sitting next to me. Oh wait, he's eating air. What are you doing? Vin, what are you doing? Does your cat do that at all? Any cat owners in comments? Anybody? Do your cats do that? So weird.
Hello.
Anyways, that's Finn. Here's my computer, Finn. What? Oh, he wants me to pet him. Hey, no love bites. But yeah, that's where he is. But let's jump into Demolition Man. That's the first song we are going to listen to out of the two. Here we go.
Let me loose, I just got big. I was pushed and I got drained. Tasted mud, tasted wine. I kissed the life I left behind. So say I choose to stick around. But I got news for this here town. I keep the ball, I catch the bus. I raise the roof for all of us.
Destination.
Christian man. As always, I'm going to start with what I think this song is about, and I'm going to do this to the best of my ability, okay? First, you guys need to know that I listen to the song and record my reactions to it, and then I listen to the song a second time with the lyrics pulled up so I can hear word for word what they're saying and get my assumptions on what I think this song is about. I do that with every song I listen to. And looking at the lyrics again, and that's what I'm looking at, I just get the vibe that it's really about a person who throws care to the wind and is everything and truly themselves, maybe. Living life on the edge, you know, throwing care to the wind. I like it says, everything and everyone and all the things I ought to be. Like, he ain't all that. He's just who he is, and he wants to be your man. But there's a line in here. Oh no, you can't play with that. Thank you. There's a line in here, and it says, here I am, your demolition man. Ben is playing with all my all my nail stuff right now. I feel like... Fit! Stop it! I feel like... I'm never getting through this. Oh my god. I feel like it's a call out to pour some sugar on me. Simply because he says, here I am, your demolition man. And if you think back to it... Oh, I love that song. Pour some sugar on me. Look at this. You're caught red-handed. Like, he's trying to get my nail glitters. Little thief. That's what I'm dealing with right now, okay? Remove those, too. Can we just start over? Let's just start over. Demolition man. Blah, blah, blah. Listen to it a second time with the lyrics. This is what I think it's about. A person... who is absolutely themselves, throw care to the wind, and don't listen to anyone or anything, and is everything you want them to be, is everything you think and want for yourself for a man. And then the line says, here I am, your demolition man. I thought, oh my god, wait, why does that sound familiar to me? I racked my brain for a minute, and then it made me think back to pour some sugar on me and the lyric, demolition woman, can I be your man? And I'm like, oh my god, I have cat hair on my lipstick. That's not what I said though. I said, oh my god, because I think this is the corresponding song to pour some sugar on me. That's what I think it's about. Let me know your guys' opinion on what you think this song is about. Leave it in the comment section down below. Now let's talk about the song itself. First off, I felt like the harmonies were incredible. They were classic Def Leppard harmonies. The boys right there, beautiful. I loved it. It almost was quite a throwback to some Hysteria vibes, you know, and that really made me happy. Some of the lines, though, were a little weak to me, but overall, I felt like this track was great. I would listen to it again. I have no problems with this. You are not filing your nails, boy. And, I mean, like, the whole bridge. I just felt like it was a little... And some of the lines I just felt were a little weird, but I did love the bringing down the walls of Wonderland line. I love that, but I guess that's just really your preference type of thing. So you may like certain parts that I didn't like. It's just, that's a preference thing. I love how this song really kind of shows how they've grown and also kind of showcases how time has grown from the 80s to almost the 2000s. This is almost Y2K, and what, this was 99, I think I saw, and I mean that it sounds incredible. So you really just see overall everything, how it's grown, and I mean the grown up opposite version of Pour Some Sugar on Me. That's really cool to hear. The drums, really, I don't know if it's just me, but at the very beginning, the drums reminisced of Motley Crue, and the song's overall kind of vibe had that, especially in the drums, some Tommy Lee there, but I don't know, that might just be me, but I heard some Motley vibes there. And the riffs were easy to listen to, easy to follow, but impressive when they needed to be. I really liked that. It really just was true to Def Leppard, just never over the top riff, but when they need to be, they're there. Also, I felt like the flow was quite hyped and fun, and I really liked that. So I think this is a great opener for the album. It really kind of sets the tone for what we're going to hear from now on, kind of that step back into their 80s style, but with a more current sound. So I'm ready to hear some more. Let's check out Promises.
Not right out, it got to me. Gonna give me some
promises. As always, we're gonna start with what I think the song is about. So I feel like it's about one of two things. One is that it is about a girl asking him how he feels about her, and he told her he loves her and that he doesn't make any promises he can't keep, because that's, I won't make promises that I can't keep. I won't make promises that I don't mean. Because he says, you want me to promise to you that everything, but that's the thing, this line. You want me to promise you that everything is true, and then he says that, I won't make promises that I can't. So if it's not about that, then he is a liar and said all this different type of things to her and realize maybe that he, I don't know, or maybe he's just an honest person and she wants him to make him make promises and he's just like, nah, I can't do that. It's probably that one. The other two sound dumb. You're seeing my brain work in current time. Okay. So I'm gonna say, but see, then he says, I told you everything. I said it all. I don't know. What do you guys think it's about? Because I'm conflicted. I am conflicted. Let me know your guys' opinions. Let's just start talking about this song, okay? And the first thing we're gonna talk about is that note. You guys, we can't go on without talking about that note. My God, that note though. Incredible. Yeah. Joe's range never ceases to amaze me. Like, it never fails. It's incredible. Just when you think you know his range, he's just like, nah, opera note, or nah, bass note. Like, and then he messes you up again, and you're just like, what else do you have in your arsenal? Like, cut it out. That's what I'm thinking. This song, and I said this earlier in Demolition Man, has a hysteria vibe to it, only just updated because they've grown and they've played with other types of sounds, and I feel like all that combined with the hysteria sound. I think that's the sound they picked for the overall vibe of this album, but with that updated sounds that they've have in their arsenal now. That's what I feel like this is coming out to sound like. I think it kind of is an updated Photograph vibe as well, and that riff is iconic. It's tearing up my speakers. Wow, it was great. This is definitely another great one. I loved both of these songs. I mean, there were parts of Demolition Man that was just lyrically a little weak, but that was it. Other than that, again, never learn. I think these are great openers, and I'm ready to hear the rest of the album. I'm excited about this. Definitely excited about. Before we go, I do want to say one more thing. I want to make it known, just because you guys, I can't believe I have to say this, but you guys, just because I don't like Vivian Campbell personally, it don't affect my opinions and how I judge songs. So I know like someone was not understanding why I didn't like Work It Out, and someone was responded it was because I didn't like Vivian Campbell. That had nothing to do with it. If you watched, I already decided way before I found out if Vivian even wrote it. That don't make any judgment on what my views are on a song. I also give dues. I think Vivian is one hell of a guitar player. That, just because I personally don't like the guy, don't mean he's not incredible of a guitar player or changes how I judge a song if he wrote it or if he's the guitar soloist on it. That just, it don't matter to me. So it's just the same like when Steve was on the albums. I didn't hate on a song just because Phil was the lead and not Thieve. So it's like that. Just because I personally don't like Vivian has nothing to do with anything when it comes to my reactions. That is just personal, and also something I don't want to talk about ever. So that is completely behind the scenes, not for you guys, okay? That is just, I might crack a joke, but it's a joke. It's not, has nothing to do with anything. It's all personal. That's it. I hope you guys understand that. So, with that said, tell me your guys' opinions on both of these songs. I'd love to hear it. Tomorrow, you guys are getting some White Lion. Can't wait, because we haven't done White Lion in a long time. We only did one video on them, so With that said, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Stay safe and well, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!